Who are all these people, students ask, and why are they helping us? These questions are often asked in a somewhat jokey way, full of wonder and gratitude, but the reality is that for some people, simply being treated with kindness can be a disorienting and even overwhelming experience.
Notorious killers.
Beyond the capacity of this prison.
Gang-related attacks.
They will erupt if it's going to.
If we don't intervene, the whole situation of mass incarceration will continue to worsen.
There are a lot of paths to prison, but most of them are characterized, at least to some degree, by academic failure.
How is it that people don't understand what's going on here?
The more opportunities we in prison have to learn, to value education, and see possibilities for ourselves, the greater the chance we will break the cycle of incarceration, not just for ourselves, but for future generations to come. Perhaps the best-kept secret in the California prison system, the overwhelming success of the Prison University Project, is overshadowed by the notion that people in prison do not have the capacity to change, and unlike other human beings, are unworthy of higher education. More often than not, the media perpetuates these ideas by sensationalizing the darker side of humanity within these walls. But ladies and gentlemen, there's indeed a bright side to this story.
Without effective educational rehabilitative programs, the increasing number of people entering and re-entering the system will have no way out of this cycle. And we as a society will have no way out of our current downward spiral of warehousing more and more of our own population.
It takes the efforts of the entire community to make education work.
People like Jody, who have the compassion to know that there are souls in here. There are human beings.
The long-term plan is a societal transformation.
Sometimes both need and hope have been replaced by a mental fog or a pervasive sense of dread and hopelessness.
Despite all of the preconceived notions about the incorrigible nature of men in prison, I've always believed I possess the power to change my life.
If your heart turns blue, I want you to remember this song is for you.
Energy and tireless efforts of the entire Prison University Project staff reminded me not only of the God-given gifts that I possess, but my responsibility to share those gifts with others here at San Quentin.